It's night five of finals at Piscina Scandoni, the venue for the swimming at the 30th Summer Universiade here in Naples. We've got four finals on the program tonight. The first event, the men's 800 meters freestyle. Germany working from the bottom here, and Spain, Poland, Russia, USA, Russia again, then Italy, and Portugal. First of the finals on night five is underway at Piscina Scandoni, the complex which has hosted some remarkable swims here over the last few nights. It's the World University Summer Games, or the Universiade. Record for this particular race is held by an Italian, a Calcinieri, who swam a 7:45 in Chinese Taipei 2 years ago, August of 2017. Now the German Henning Mulletner in lane one, so closest to us down here, has the fastest time amongst the lot of them. He is the top seed, but he, when it came to qualifying for this, they were all just doing enough to get into that final. Well, you can see it's not a big pace at the moment, already 53 seconds off that world record pace, so they've all just gone out alongside each other. They'll be keeping a wary eye on each other, though. Just about a perfect line through here. Will someone take it from the wall here? Bit of movement in lane two. And off the wall goes Escrits Minosa. He's looking across to his right. He can see with a big line up there all behind him. Escrits Minosa starred at the Spanish long distance pool championships. As a few countries have those, really long distance. He swam the 5,000 meters and won that. Impressed a lot of people. He's got a birthday coming up on the 15th of this month, when he'll turn 22. No, he won't. He's only not quite 20. I'll start again. He's about to turn 21 in September. I've got such small printing in front of me, my glasses get slightly steamed up inside and I can't see anything. I'm making excuses. Lanes 1, 2 and 5. So Mulletner, Escrits Minosa and Norman. Some just seem to be really loping, and yet the power they're putting in under the water is quite misleading, because they move through the water so quickly. through to the 400, so the halfway stage now. And the screws are being turned on just a little bit by Norman, and Nikitin is aware of what's going on. He's in lane four. The American is to his left in lane five. Just a couple out from them. In lane seven is Lamberti of Italy. And he's just cruising into the shot at the moment. Up there, second from the top. Turning first though Norman, then Nikitin, then Lamberti. And the crowd's just spotted that on the big screen, and so they give him every encouragement. Field now being torn apart a little. It was a one big line. It was a pedestrian pace for a long time. Norman. Watch out too for Zabrowski here in the white cap. He's just starting to make his presence felt. Swam the 400 at the Olympic Games in Rio for Poland. He's in lane three and turns in fourth place. Still Norman though in Nikitin. Oh, great turn by the Pole. Zabrowski. They're both the leaders are breathing the other way. And Zabrowski is just picking him up on their blind spot. So too, the Italian up on the top, Lamberti. And inside Lamberti is Maximov of the Russian Federation. This is anyone's race now. Norman has been overtaken by Nikitin. Norman stays with him. Oh, Lamberti. Whoa, watch out up at the top. The crowd is spurring him on. Also, Zabrowski. Oh, great turn by the Pole. Nikitin holding, looking to his right, sees Norman. Zabrowski comes to within half a meter and clearly in third place now. Not the greatest of turns, but still good enough to close, and so too Lamberti. Now the two leaders are looking directly at the Pole who had closed the gap on them, and he's looking away. Nikitin, this is coming to a sprint now. Who's got the best turn out of Nikitin and Norman? Off the wall together, 0.08. Zabrowski just behind. Couldn't quite glance Lamberti. He's back a bit now. Oh, and he's putting in the big kick. Watch the splash from the feet of these swimmers. Nikitin pulls away. Nikitin wins it. Norman second, Zabrowski third, which means that Lamberti is touched out in fourth place. It looked comfortable at the finish, didn't it? Half a body length, maybe more ahead. Norman and Nikitin switched the lead time and again, and they both appreciate it's been a fabulous race. Zabrowski continued to close, but it was a near thing between he and Matteo Lamberti. Nikitin wins the first final of tonight, the fifth night of finals. The men's 800 metres freestyle, 7 minutes 56.65. Nick Norman of the USA is second. Filip Zaborowski of Poland is third. Medalists go centre stage now and pose for many photos. They're the top performers from the men's 800 metres freestyle. And now we move on to the next of our races, the final of the women's 200 metres breaststroke. Well, this is going to be intriguing. So, who's got it in them to win this tonight? The women's 200 breaststroke. Escobedo has form. Schoonmaker has the medal so far with the gold in the 100. Watanabe way up in the top. We'll see her in a moment. A bronze in the 100. South Africans doing well with Schoonmaker, the gold in the 100. Lovemore a gold in the 50 fly and Waddle a gold equal in the 50 metres backstroke. So they're going well, and particularly well is Tatjana Schoonmaker in lane four, has that slight advantage going into the touch now. 0.35 over the Great Britain swimmer in lane number one, Jocelyn Elliott. Is Escobedo moving yet? This is a lovely shot of the style of Schoonmaker. And Elliott's swimming exceptionally well here in lane one. Someone appearing on the other side of Schoonmaker, and that is Escobedo, of course. And Escobedo might just take over, and Schoonmaker looks to have dropped back through the list, really. Oh no, just second, but the others have gained dramatically. Her turns are always good. Up she comes. Just keeping pace with the woman on her left, Emily Escobedo. Elliott still in the picture. Watanabe up at the top, just back at the moment. Oh, now Schoonmaker. Just driving so much power underneath the wall, underneath the water, and now off the wall. She's got a slight edge, that's 0.29. Retains a beautiful form. Finds that next gear. 25 to go, still a lot in this race. Oh my word, Escobedo is fighting back on her. Shorter stroke from Schoonmaker, she gets there, she pulls away through to win it, and win it quite comfortably as it turns out. 2:22. 2:22.92, just out of that game's record. She's really worked hard, and that's a great shot. The two embrace. They've been the two everyone's talked about in this event throughout the Universiade. And when we see the results, you see there was not much in it. 0.73 back to Escobedo. Watanabe eventually got up for third, 1.26 seconds down. Then Corbett, Chukunova, Fangio, Elliott and Metz. Oh, always watch out for those in the outside lanes. And Watanabe, a proof of that, slipping in for third place. The gold medal, her second of the meeting, goes to South Africa's Tatjana Schoenmaker, 2:22.92. Emily Escobedo of the USA is the silver medalist, and Kanako Watanabe of Japan, the bronze. The women's 200 meters breaststroke. Schoenmaker touches her second gold. Watanabe gets her second bronze in the breaststroke events. Team's having a lot of fun here. It's a typical swim meet. The three best 200 meter breaststroke swimmers in the world of university swimming. Ready for this, the men's 100 free. You can expect that noise when it comes to the 100. Indiana University Bloomington for Apple. Cream of the sprinters here in Naples hit the water together, carving out that first 25 very quickly. It's the 100 freestyle final. Just a lot of splashing, huge amount of water being sent skywards from those big powerful feet. And in lane 3 and lane 8 we see Jackson go, Apple in 5, Cumberledge in 2, Young in 8. Back they come. Lots of the crowd standing, searching. Lane 5, Zach Apple, gold in the 200, looking to do a double here. They come at him. He's too good. Apple. Jackson, 1-2, the USA. Ferreira belts the water in delight because he has managed to get up for that bronze medal. 48.01. That's as fast as he's gone in a while. Zach Apple, 48.03 last year. So he's hitting good form. Tate Jackson. The big smile. And Marco Ferreira, not quite number one, but close to it. Zachary, or Zach Apple, from Indiana University Bloomington, was too good for them all. Superbly controlled race, had plenty when it mattered. He receives the 100 meters freestyle gold medal. Somewhere back in his bag or back at his room, he's got the gold medal from the 200 meters freestyle. It's two golds for Zachary Apple. Final remaining, the women's 100 fly. Deep breathing, calming, relaxation. We points here from Diamante of Brazil in lane one. That's Lovemore in four. Horpink of Germany. Oh, what a challenge she'll give. The last final of the night, the women's 100 metres butterfly. The outstanding South African Taylor Lovemore already with one gold behind her in the 50 metres, the sprint. She takes the lead. She has that 50 speed, and she's also a very good 100 racer as well. Horpink to her left. Touch alongside her. Lovemore just almost a dead heat. Zandringa is in third place. Off the wall. What a great turn from Lovemore. That was stunning. Now though, 25 to go, and Horpink starts to fly. Horpink comes up alongside Lovemore. Horpink goes past Lovemore. So too does Soma. Oh, this is going to be touch. What a touch. What a touch. What a finish. Lovemore, Luta, Horpink. How on earth did Lovemore win that? She doesn't know. I think she agrees with all of us watching that. It really did look as though she was gone with 10 metres left. Lisa Horpink, well, there it is. Lovemore first, Luther second, Horpink third, South Africa. South Africa's Taylor Lovemore has scored the double here. The 100 and the 50 gold medals. 58.74, 58.82, 58.87, fourth Isoma, 58.89. What a finish that was. Lovemore, Luther, Horpink. Just love to see the touch again at the finish. Three medalists get together for a group photo. The women's 100 metres butterfly. The medalists. There's no doubt they'll be seeing each other plenty of times in the future in the pool.